So we think a lot about, in fact, this week we've been talking a lot about bias and thinking about self-interest. And what's the difference between, like, with the story about LIPA's power being out? Your power was out 2 weeks, therefore you are highly motivated to investigate LIPA. What's wrong with that approach, and what's right with that approach?
I think, and I knew when I said that I was going to get asked about that, I knew it, because very rarely do I have a personal investment in a story. This nursing home story, I really couldn't have cared less about it before I started it. And then I got into it, and I realized the average age at this nursing home is 43, and I met the patients, and I got very involved. So I think it is risky to have a personal involvement, but you have to try to be aware of it, disclose it, and check yourself so that you're not going overboard. And I think if you disclose it to your editors, which I did just about every day, they'll help you keep it in line and make sure you're not going over the line. But the fact is, you know, we all talk about journalists being independent. We're people. We vote. Some of us get married, some of us have children. I mean, we're human beings, and you don't give up your rights to citizenship when you become a journalist. Now, one thing that I did do, I am not registered in a political party. And in New York, that means I can't vote in primaries. So I'm giving up my right to vote in political primaries. And the reason I'm not registered in a political party is that I know these guys, the first thing they do, if you write a negative story about a Democrat, he's going to check to see if you're a registered Republican and use it against you, or vice versa. So there are some things you need to do to step back, but I don't think you give up your right to live a life